So we have nothing but woke news last week. And one huge one is Pokemon Go decided to strip the male and female option of their game and introduce everyone as genderless. And I mean, oh, failure, sir. So Pokemon Go decided to just strip the male and female side. And you're just like, why? And while the media like always gives you headlines like BS, like, oh, something bad happens. You look at the headlines and it says, Pokemon Go, praised by gamers for introducing gender fluid avatars. And you're like,
stop the cap.
Oh, stop the cap. People are furious about this. So we know it's cap. It is cringe. Cringier than the time when we had freaking Hillary Clinton telling us that we should Pokemon Go to the polls. You know that crazy assness.
I don't know who created Pokemon Go, but I'm trying to figure out how we get them to have Pokemon go to the polls.
Bruh.
In the real world, people are outraged why their female characters look like big old buff masculine men and why their male counterparts look like fat, ugly activists. And I mean, man, sir.
Yeah, Pokemon is cooked. After the failed buggy launch of Pokemon Violet and Scarlet a couple years ago, you would think Pokemon would learn not to piss off their fan base. But of course, that ESG money is good, so they're gonna do it anyway. They've gone the route of making each character and the creator of Pokemon Go look androgynous. What do I mean by that? They don't want the women to look like women, and they don't want the men to look like men because they don't want to upset a certain demographic. Now listen, I'm all for creating whatever character you want. That's cool with me. But making the defaults look like this? What the? And I'm not a vocal minority. Everybody on Twitter is roasting these motherfuckers right now. The rabbit hole gets even deeper because the ones that consulted them on these changes is this company right here, which is associated with that other BS company, Sweet Baby Inc. Look, if I was a logical person, I would see these connecting dots and realize that the people that keep making these changes don't actually care about the things that they're touching. Who the f*** plays a Pokemon game and says, well, I want my character to look as ambiguous as possible? No one. Especially not the Japanese of all people. Why would you try to mess with their shit? You know how they are about their culture. Why would you mess with them? And again, I don't know why this has to be stated, but I'm going to state it. There's nothing wrong with inclusivity. There's something wrong when you use inclusivity to exclude people. And this is just another case of this bullshit. Like, it just keeps happening over and over again. Like, when are they going to learn?
So let's keep it a bug, okay? So, and no surprise, the company that is responsible for this is this company that's named GamerX. So, oh, I see what they did there. They put a Y in it. So it's GamerX. Hey, that's creative. I'll give you guys props for that one. But anyways, which is another DEI, or Diverse Equality and Inclusion company that in plain English straight up wokeifies your company with identity politics and cusses and pretty much just causes the company a lot of money. Same thing, just like the Bud Light fiasco, you get the GSE score, which again, that GSE score is like a woke meter. It's a general self-efficiency scale score. It's stupid, which forces your company to put rainbow related and more gender identity stuff in your product, which later, of course, causes you to lose a lot of money. Or in simpler terms, once you go woke, you go broke, sir. And again, for that one, Kina, get up. Oh, man, sir.
Brother, what's that? What's that, brother?
So, we have GamerX. It wasn't running the company profitably, and even the IRS freaking revoked their exempt for 3 consecutive years, folks. So they're in trouble already. So you should have known this thing is sketchy. They came in and made all this mayhem. And all these companies like GamerX, MidBoss, or the dreaded, I believe it's called Sweet Baby Inc. We know they ruin companies. They wokeify them. So with sexual misconduct allegations, that's right, the people that work there are petty with inappropriate behavior. No surprise. And when it came with the actual game update, now we're actually talking about the game. It's riddled with all kinds of freaking bugs, sir. So it's not even playable, bro. I mean, you can play it, but it comes with massive amount of bugs. So here's some of them. It's in the point that there was an up. Okay, so if you put on a headset in the game that would give you, you know, like you know, headphones or hats and stuff, it gives you the nastiest crease in the top of your head, bro. It is hilarious. the shade of color is so off that if you would want to change the shade of color of your skin, people quickly realize the limited amount of colors either made you whiter than Casper the Friendly Ghost, or in the point you wonder why there isn't a color wheel in the freaking first place.
Well, as we all know, the Avatar update is here, and holy shit, they got me looking so white you can easily confuse me for a grain of rice. Call me Edward Cullen because I'd be looking so pale like those vampires from Twilight. Oh hey, look, it's me, Casper, the Friendly Ghost. I know what you're thinking. I look like the Michelin Man.
And then we had the characters with massive camel toes. Yes, what? You heard me right. They gave you skins in your pants and you get camis on the bottom. While your character is overweight, oh, or they put a skirt on it and you get everything, man. Sir. Down to the people missing the regular male and female character list and the end. So people making memes about that too. Honest, why did they do all of this? Why is this so important? It's simple. Wokeness. For the 0.01% that define themselves as trans and not feeling appreciated, you screw over the rest of the 99.9%. And again, for that one, can I get a man, sir, you can't make this up. This is clown world. So in this update, all it did is make everyone fat, ugly, and gross, and in the point that people are asking for their dang money back since the new update ruined all their add-ons. Can you imagine? You went and you put a bunch of money on this game, you pop it up after the update, and you realize if you're a girl, your character gained like 30 pounds. Now everything looks like shit. Or you got your buff-ass character, usually it's scrawny, but you realize, what the heck? Why does my character got sides and corners or some? Because it's gender neutral and you get a female character, she has a bulge. Or you lose a female hips. It's weird. It makes no sense. Bro, we are truly in clown world. And all I gotta say, bro, regardless of your politics or anything, we could all agree the Pokemon Go update was complete garbage. And how ended is that? So if you made it this far, bro, give me a like. And if you like the dumbass things I say, bro, subscribe. And that'll be all.
Team Mama out.